Hey guys, hope you're doing well. Today I'm going to tell you about the Canada PR process for 2023 with all the newest available updates from IRCC. I'll be elaborating on the Express Entry program and let you know the step-by-step process, the newly adopted 5-digit NOC codes that you have to now use, and show you how to create an Express Entry profile completely for free. If you get your PR, you can then fly to Canada along with your family members and they will get all the benefits of a PR holder as well. In this video, I'll be telling you all about the Express Entry program for 2023, how you can check your eligibility, all the documents you'll need, the exact websites and links that you have to use, how to register yourself or create a GC key for your IRCC account, step-by-step instructions to create your Express Entry profile, and the 7 steps to apply for your PR along with your dependent family members as well, so do watch the video till the end. Hey guys, this is Jason from Dream Canada. If you're new to the channel, I show people how to save their money and immigrate to new countries through my videos without the help of any immigration consultants or agents or lawyers. You can find all the process instructions for you to apply on your own through this channel. Subscribe now because all the information provided here is completely free and I answer all your queries in the comments section and on my social handles on Instagram and Twitter, so don't forget to follow us there as well. You can even get in touch with us directly via WhatsApp on the number shared on the screen. So right off the bat, you'll have to follow 7 basic steps before you can fly to Canada, from getting a language test, to creating your IRCC account, to finally getting your COPR and ETA visa stamped, and I'll be walking you through each one of them so it's easy for you to understand. Before you start any steps though, you have to check your eligibility for the Express Entry program directly on the IRCC website. Don't go to any agents or consultants for this as it's a very easy process online and you can do this yourself in just 5 minutes. Agents will charge you a huge sum just to do this simple thing. I'll add a link to this IRCC webpage in the description box. So as you can see, you can check if you're eligible for any one of or all of the 3 streams under the Express Entry program, which are the Canadian Experience class for those with at least 1 year of Canadian work experience, the Federal Skilled Worker program for foreign skilled workers, and the Federal Skilled Trades program for those with experience in a skilled trade. So what you have to do is click on the first option here, which will let you enter in details like your age, language score, education, work experience, and details about your family members and ties to Canada. Click on Check Your Eligibility towards the bottom and select a province that you might be interested in. Now you'll get an option to select the language test you've taken or you're planning to take. If you've already taken your language test, enter in the date here. Remember that it has to be not longer than 2 years ago. If you've already taken the test, enter in your scores here. Otherwise, enter an estimate score that you think you can achieve when you take the test. Remember that you need at least CLB-7 to make an Express Entry profile. If you've taken a French test as well, enter in the details here, otherwise select none. Next, enter in your work experience details and the tier category which it falls under. If you don't know your tier category or new 5-digit NOC code, follow the steps in this detailed video linked in the description box and enter in your code here. Once you click on next, the page will give you a personal reference code which you'll need while creating your Express Entry profile. You can choose to either print this page or just save the reference number. As you can see here, you'll also be given step-by-step instructions on creating and submitting your profile along with links to create a GC key, which are basically login details for your secure IRCC account. We'll come to that later. Now let's come to the first step, which is taking a language test. Now for English, you have to take the CELPIP or IELTS GT or general training, as IELTS Academic is for study visas. For French, you can take the TEF or TCF. You can choose to take both English and French tests if you want to score better, but you can get selected with even a single test, so if you know just English or just French, that will also suffice. The scores you'll need for each test is mentioned on the IRCC website. Make sure that you meet or exceed the minimum scores mentioned here. The Pearson English Test or PTE is a new English test that was developed to meet IRCC's language proficiency requirements for Canadian immigration applicants. Like the other language tests, the PTE will also test on the 4 areas of language ability, which are reading, writing, listening, and speaking. Kindly note though that IRCC will begin to accept test results from PTE tests only by late 2023. The next step is getting your ECA or Education Credential Evaluation for the education you've completed outside Canada. You don't need an ECA for any study course completed in Canada and for your 10th and 12th grade mark sheets. The whole point of getting an ECA is to prove that your education meets Canadian education standards, and this step can be completed at the same time as getting your language test done. You can get your ECA from designated organizations like CES, ICAS, IQAS, ICES, and WES. WES is the most widely used organization, which also provides the fastest ECA. I made a detailed video on how you can get your ECA from WES online. I'll add a link to it in the description box. The fee for an ECA is between 200 to 250 Canadian dollars, and the processing time is as quick as 7 days for WES. The next step is finding your NOC. Now, IRCC has recently switched from NOC 2016 to the NOC 2021 codes on November 16, 2022, which are 5-digit codes which are based on the training, education, experience, and responsibilities for each job position. If you don't know your tier category or new 5-digit NOC code, you can get this information on the official IRCC website on the Find Your NOC webpage. I've also made a detailed tutorial for this, so you can just follow the steps mentioned in the video linked in the description box. When you know your NOC code and you have your ECA and language test results, you're now ready to create your Express Entry profile or IRCC account on the IRCC webpage. Your IRCC account is basically where you will start your Express Entry application. This is where you'll pay all your fees, and this is where you'll get important communication, messages, or notifications from IRCC with regard to your profile or application status. Do remember that creating an Express Entry profile is completely free, and it just requires an email address and requires you to create a username and password for your profile, which is called your GC key login details. Instructions on creating a GC key by registering on the IRCC website are provided online. You just have to click on register if you don't have an account and follow the step-by-step instructions mentioned for registering with the GC key after that. Either way, I've made a detailed video on registering and making a GC key for your Express Entry profile, which does not take more than 5 minutes, so you can have a look at that tutorial video. I've linked it in the description box below. Now, what happens after you create your Express Entry profile? After you create an Express Entry profile, you just have to wait for an ITA or an invitation to apply for Express Entry draws that are held every second week. If your CRS score is higher than the cutoff scores in these draws, you'll be sent an ITA. There are a few things that you can do from your end to get a higher CRS score, so your profile will be picked faster. I've covered this in another video, so do have a look at that before you create an Express Entry profile. Kindly note that you won't have to enter in your child's details until you receive an ITA, so don't panic if you don't see a form for your dependent children while creating your Express Entry account. Now, what do you do after you get your ITA? You will get 60 calendar days after you receive an ITA to submit a complete application, which means uploading all your documents and paying your fees. Kindly note that these are 60 calendar days and not business days, so it includes weekends and holidays as well. The documents you'll need to scan and upload are your ECA report, language test report, all the pages of your passport, CIC format work reference letters from each employer, official bank letter and account statements in the CIC format as your proof of funds, Canadian job offer letter if applicable to you, provincial nomination letter if you have one, your marriage, divorce or spouse's death certificate if applicable, the birth or adoption certificate of your child if you have any children, and photographs in a specified CIC format. If you don't respond to your ITA within 60 days, IRCC will take your profile out of the pool, and to be considered for future draws, you'll have to fill out a new Express Entry profile. Since some of the documents take some time to be issued to you, it's always best to start gathering your documents as soon as you create your Express Entry profile. After you submit your complete application, it'll be reviewed by IRCC. Immigration officers will now assess the information and documents you've provided in your application, and you'll receive your COPR or Confirmation of Permanent Residence document if you're approved. If you're outside Canada, you have to carry the COPR document when you fly to Canada, and if you're already inside Canada on a work permit or a student visa, you can approach an officer at a Canadian port of entry or an IRCC office and they'll sign and date your COPR, which you can use to enter Canada. For both instances, your PR card will be physically mailed to your registered address in Canada on a later date. If you've included your spouse and children in your application, they will receive their COPR at the same time as you. Along with your COPR, you'll also receive a confirmation email from IRCC for your ETA or Electronic Travel Authorization, which is basically a temporary visa that allows you to travel to Canada. You'll get 30 days to submit your photographs and get this ETA visa stamped in your passport at your nearest VFS center. Alright guys, so that was how you can get your Canada PR in 2023. For more immigration and travel tips, subscribe to this channel now. Do like this video if you like the content and comment what topic you would like to hear about next. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to subscribe for regular updates on immigration and don't forget to follow us on Instagram as well. I wish you the best of luck for your application and hope you have a great day.